TNC. Now they could open up their pool. And now your offlane would be more scared, but...
Nope. I think what TNC should do is they give Raven this rune. He buys a sentry immediately.
How about Tims and Sam Age can just kill off Arteezy?
That's another way of getting gold, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah, Arteezy. You try and turn around when he's gone for... Like, he's already gone for the precision aura. That's going to happen when you're running a 5-range lineup.
Yeah, this rune is TNC's, I think. They're going to get 3.
Yeah. No, Crit's going to try and contest it as well.
He is going to regret that. Oh, Tims.
He didn't cut through! He ran around! And now, well, where's your Burrow Strike? It's going to be 3 runes again to TNC. That's how last game started, but this time around, First Blood will go the way of TNC. And there's nothing Arteezy can do about it. Zai, with the pulling, completely messed up the equilibrium, but it's that bonus damage that he's had early on that's allowed him to go 18-5. He's got more CS than Arteezy has managed to achieve. Like, and this is against like the safe lane PA, who's now 13-0. You managed to catch up a little bit underneath the tower. And, well, okay, there goes Zai, so I did do something about him now.
Up like this. What really is going to make things come together is the first couple of fights, especially that the Batrider manages to set up for the Radiant. If they work, then this gold lead of PG will not be sufficient. Attack.
Raven's trying to kill off Crit, rotated up towards the top lane. Arteezy with just the level 1 Gust, dissuading Raven, but the lane change up. Let's see how long it lasts for. You've already got Zai here. Raven needs someone to jump back out to. They TP'd in to help out, but it was Sam H who went to the shrine. He didn't actually go all the way in, but Crit and Arteezy, they've come out so far to try and fight Raven that maybe Sam H can capitalize. Tim's moving up too. They see him thanks to the Dire Observe Ward. Arteezy completes his TP out to safety. Zai, Chikuchi will get him away to safety.
Having a good time. Generally, I would say this is a...
Chikuchi just got burnt from the Weaver. They've got a 3-second window now to catch out Zai. Lasso's available. They're going to commit it, but the Dream Call from Universe trying to counter off the gank. Zai, he's able to Chikuchi himself away to safety, and Batrider will fall. Is TNC being aggressive, but underneath the Tier 1 tower?
That Siege Creep just did 100 damage in one shot. And they were not ready for
He's not ready for this. At least he has his BT, so even if he dies right now, which he definitely does, he still has his BTs available, but Samael going for more. 1437 burns the shrine. Sam H was thinking about coming into it, into the regeneration area, but now this just allows EG to look for a third kill, going one after the other. Universe was going to be safe. The lasso just cannot control anything. Actually, need that Aghanim Scepter up. Like, everyone needs to be blinded in this game. Oh, they say using regeneration rune as bait. Samael, hello! Threw the arrow up, looking for a target. They go for the curse. 1437 doesn't have mana. Now he does for the global silence, allowing to find the kill onto Samael. Sam H will take it for the 451 gold. And they'd love to get a little bit more. The tier 1 tower appears to be their target.
Oh, Universe.
Yeah, he's managed to find one. Burrow Strike from Tim's this time. He was looking to catch Universe mid jaunt away. The Universe Dream Call holds Tim's close. Sam H in position. Crit. Not finding any opportunity. They don't have reveal against the SK, allowing him to go for another Burrow Strike. You do have the silence from Universe, at least allowing. Okay, no, there it is. The lasso is not allowing for anything. I was going to say, allowing Sam H just to watch everything going on.
This dire lineup. Building in toward the Deso. Actually, we might need to wait with the rest of the items.
They Moonlight
this
Shadow.
Is a big moment. Sam H could make a big play here.
The smoke is broken now. They don't have detection. Moonlight Shadow will wear off in 2 seconds' time. So they Firefly up. The Sentry Ward is down. So they found the target with the False Promise. Allows Samael to bail out this one. The Dream Call, making sure Sanky can stay exactly where he is. He has his Epicenter available, but EG, don't lose anybody. A quick Sandstorm. Zai, Burrow Strike away. Tim's on the run from him. He has enough damage. Of course, he's got a freaking Drow Ranger behind him. So Zai, Shikuchi's forward. They want Trigger off the shrine, and they're gonna get it. Universe jaunted himself into the middle of all of TNC. They're bailing out of the shrine.
Oh, the arrow!
The arrow will connect onto Tim's. He knew what he was gonna do that time, but no one from EG is close enough, or is he?
He's gonna kill on their way out.
That Shadow Blade being put to use already as the Batrider Tims, the Burrow Strike. It'll save Sam H. He went down to 60 HP. The Global Silence combining with the Epicenter. They turn around onto Drow Ranger with the Flame Break. She'll burn from this, or will she? The damage. Looking for her life. She'll stay alive.
Okay.
No, here comes another Sentry Ward. Cuckoo with his TP forward finds the kill onto Arteezy. Crit did everything humanly possible with no False Promise.
Toby, I think he's gonna die. Oh, it actually takes longer than I thought. Maybe he's fine.
Man, get the bug off that 1437. is the infestation. Raven's going in. The silence is there from Universe with the lasso quickly from Samael. Support is there. Crit this time around. He had the false promise to break it. But you've lost Samael. You're losing more. Maybe Raven, this is his time to shine. Needs the vision once more. Zai fighting an infest. Cuckoo brings him the support. March the machines to give the cover fire. PA still trying to get the bug off him and get rid of that negative armor. Zai running through the march of the machines. Revealed for half a second and gets rocketed to oblivion.
This Arteezy Drow that is closing in on Silver Edge and then maybe start opening up on the PA. Take her
Radiant
out first. Good scan from the Radiant. They're reading this movement very well. And might be looking for a counterplay. Everything is ready on both sides for a fight.
Oh, Samael, the leap forward. Needs hit the arrow with a dream coil. Okay, that's where you use your magical burst damage to find the kill.
Man, the Tinker Ward.
Wait. Are they going to realize that Roshan's being done? Does PA have a look inside the pit? Roshan so low. Raven's walking straight past it. Now Roshan gets triggered. He'll realize it. The Burrow Strike, it catches two, including the Jakuchiing. Weaver. Mr. Invisible Arteezy just walks straight underneath
Raven,
it.
I don't...
They see Tims again. This is how Tims died last time on the top lane. Hiding in the trees, thought he was fine, but the dire vision, the Observer Ward just sees where the SK is prepared.
See, if Samael shows on this bottom wave, they could go for a play.
Samael shows.
EGR are splitting up now. They're pinging him out. This is a dead puck if they see it.
Yeah, such a long way, but it's still a Yule Scepter on the puck. He just blinked. He orbed.
He's dead.
The question is, can he phase shift
fast.
In time? He's able to do so. Global silence. He's got the Yule Scepter available as well. Breaking free. Universe into the phase shift. Not only does he bait out the gank, he'll escape the gank. And Global silence got burned for it. Bottom lane TPs are kicking in. Tims gets the Burrow Strike out. Looking for the kill over on Zai. Rocket Supply 4. They saw which way Zai went. He went north. But there's no follow-up. In fact, Tim just going in into a different angle. It's to the Mirana. The Burrow Strike in. Arteezy, the epicenter is out. They dust him up to the reveal is on Arteezy. A gust creates a little bit of space, but not enough. Double sentries being planted down.
Aegis?
Yeah.
Oh, they stopped the TP out from Tinker. That's really big.
Cuckoo's got nothing left to fight with. 1437 can curse all he wants. Cuckoo kills himself on the edge of the Dream Call. The PA can do the work. Arteezy will fall. Both the sentries actually paying off. Now they turn their attention towards Zai. False Promise cannot protect him from the damage output that this PA can do, and they're looking for more. It's crit. Raven will have himself a double kill. Tim's the Burrow Strike barely missing Universe. They could have been all dead. At the same time, Arteezy being initiated on that blink Burrow Strike. He's the bigger kill. Stans his TP. They need a crit, and with the damage they have, it will be enough.
Oh.
Woo! Ah, goodbye, Universe.
I love playing this hero.
This
guy is going to kill everyone if they don't get under control.
There goes the arrow. They're inside of Roshan. The PA illusion's on its way in too. They deal with it quickly. Committing Rift as well as some decent abilities. He's already triggered off his aura. And Tims, well, wait for the timing. Roshan is low. Stifling Dagger goes in. Rockets as well. Roshan killed by the dive. And the epicenter! TNC! Lacquering it on top of Evil Genius. Arteezy. Chris trying to keep him alive. Maybe it was enough heal. We'll see if he does pop or not. He doesn't. He's back to full life. They had the buyback from the Weaver. They need to win this fight. But Raven, he's in the thick of it. Looking for the crits. Their mates will fall. They'll lose the Gem of True Sight. The Burrow Strike creating a little bit more space here from Tims. They need a little bit more here. TNC. They haven't done it just yet. 1437 will fall. Is their buybacks. You've still got Tims as well as Raven. This two-man basher army killing off Evil Geniuses. Raven with the ultra kill.
Gamble play, I think it was the right choice to try to go for it. But if they get caught like that, three or four-man laser twice, epicenter, three-man burrow, you're just not winning that fight. But they kind of had to do something. They felt like the game was slipping away.
Are they going to force this? The Burrow Strike! The Sentry Ward was down. They saw him with a fresh Abyssal Blade. The front lines. Zai is gone. That's a dive back for him. And Cuckoo's looking for more. Crit has to false promise himself, allowing them to lasso Universe, bringing him down. And the bottom racks. It was Evil Geniuses that helped TNC fall apart. Now the shoe is most definitely on the other foot. And they get another blink Burrow. Crit wall fall. Arteezy trying to be the cannon under the tier 4 towers. They will actually bring down Sam H. The PA into the back lines. The laser, the rockets, the bash. Arteezy will fall. And EG will lose a second lane of racks guaranteed. The question is, how much longer do they stick in this game? Do they believe they still take
us? Yeah, it's a fair point that he could have gone for a fourth step after that Shadow Blade, or maybe even before, and then finished the Silver Edge.
Oh, here they
definitely
come.
Hurt him.
Moonlight Shadow, they're right on top of TNC. How do they do it? The Global Silence 1437, cancelling them off. Zai is low. Does he have a way out of this one? Will he survive long enough? The Epicenter, BKB at least protects Arteezy for the moment, but Cuckoo into the trees, spamming out the damage, and Raven crits against Simail. Look at the damage! They can't even hit him! They're trying and trying, but the blind are hitting the very, very visible. EG will lose 4 and the game. TNC will get a 1-1 result by taking game 2 in this first series of TI7.